And I think you know you people have installed SQL Server and Visual Studio. How many of you have done with these installations? Yes, you can put it down in the comments if it is done. Yes, very good. Abdullah done, Kamal Islam done, Muhammad done. Wilson is also done with this. David, what about David? Are you done with the installation? Very good, very good. Then second task, have you all gone through HTML and CSS videos? You can type in yes if you have gone through it. Very good. Muhammad has gone through this. Kamal Islam has only finished HTML, fine. And I'm okay, fine. Raminder, are you done with Raminder Kaur? Are you done with installation of SQL Server and Visual Studio? Abdullah is done with 50%, that's fine. Wilson has to finish, yes, but I need to finish today. Okay, very good. So today we will see how a newbie, a person who is totally new to the world of web development, and how he can or how they can design a static website using free templates. See, what I assume is that you have some basic understanding of HTML and CSS by now. I assume that you have a basic understanding of HTML and CSS. You know what are the tags, you know, you are aware of div tag, you are aware of attributes, you are aware of classes, that is CSS. So this is my assumption. You might not be an expert in it, but you know what is what. Now, for example, if I just right click on this page and say view page source. So this is the source code. By looking at this, I hope you people can understand. Okay, this is an HTML file. Okay, it has head tag. Fine. So here, till here it is head tag. So this is body tag. There is a div tag. Are you all getting my point? This is what I want you to understand. That's it by this time. Okay, div tag. Okay, fine. This is a div tag. Good. And there is a button we have. So by looking at this, I hope you can understand there is a button title. So you can see almost all are div tags. And there is something called as class. Class is an attribute. So it has some design related to it. So by looking at this, you people should understand. And there is something called as voice.js. There is also a JavaScript file. Now by looking at this, you people should not think that what is this? Is this some Greek or Latin? No. Yes, this is CSS file. So this is a style sheet. Fine. This is JS file. Okay, this is JavaScript file. So this is what I want you to understand after going through my video tutorials of HTML, CSS and JavaScript. I don't want you to become expert. And I hope everybody are now familiar with these terms and terminologies. When I say tag, right? When I say attribute, when I say element. So now you people are aware of this. So this is my assumption from the assignment that I have given. Second thing, I assume that you might have already installed Visual Studio. Visual Studio 2019, you should have installed this. Right. Now let me go. So today we will see how a newbie with the basic understanding of HTML, CSS and JavaScript, they can develop a portfolio, as I have given in the WhatsApp group. You might have seen that link. You can see this. If I click on this mttfolio.manzoorthetrainer.com, now you know what, by the end of today's session you will be in a position to develop this kind of portals just in 1 hour. There is also a contact us form, home. Now what do you think? Do we code this from scratch? No. In your real world applications, you never code anything from scratch. We people are developers and we have lot of templates which are available. We will Google for the template and we will download the template required. Whatever the template we need, we download it. Now, for example, this is the template that we have. I'll click on the template. Devfolio. Now this template, I can download it and I can work with it. It's free template, but on one condition. Condition is that I should have the copyrights. You can see this copyrights Devfolio. I should not remove these copyrights. If you want to remove this copyright, you can purchase it for some $5, $6, or $10, or $12. That's it. You can see it's live demo. I'll click on the live demo. I'm teaching you business. This is what people do. They develop websites. They'll take some, you know, hundreds of dollars and they say that we'll give you a website. So just they'll spend some $10, $12. They'll buy a template and they'll edit it. And that is what I'm going to teach you now. Now what I will do, I'll download this and it's up to you. Whatever you want, you can download it from here. If you like this, if you want to watch the demo of this, you can watch the demo here. And if you want, you can download this and you can edit this. It's up to you. So I'll click on this and I will download this. So Devfolio, it is a free, show in folder, free website template. I'll cut it from here. I'll go to e:// part-time bootcamp, pre-bootcamp. I'll paste it here. I got the complete website. I'll just right click. And I'll say extract. I'm going to extract it here. So we got everything in Devfolio folder. Devfolio. You have your complete website here. If you want to see, you can double click this index.html. You have your complete website. See home, about, services, work, blog, contact. Till this, do anybody have any doubt? I want one yes from everyone. If you do not have any doubt, write down yes. So I don't think we need any kind of, you know, technical skills to download something. This is the simplest thing, right? Now this is the path, my dev folio path. I'll copy this path. My project is here. E: part-time bootcamp 1, pre-bootcamp dev folio. Now I will go to Visual Studio. See what we have done. This is the link. I have clicked on this link. So here we have lot of free templates. Whatever the free template I want, I have clicked on that free template and I have downloaded it. Once I download, I'll go to this show folder. So it is in the download folder, and I have just copied it to E: part-time bootcamp, pre-bootcamp. So it was a zip file. I have extracted it, and in dev folder, I got the complete project or complete website. Now I have copied this path. Now I'll go to Visual Studio. I think many of you might be using this Visual Studio 2019 for the first time. So now I'll go for Visual Studio 2019. Now I'll say continue without code. I don't want to have any code. I'll just open Visual Studio. That's it. Continue without code. I'll click on continue without code. See, if you forget the steps, don't worry. We are recording this. You can watch again and look at the steps. Don't try to write down while I am teaching. Don't try to by heart the steps. Just to see whatever I am doing, is it meaningful and you people understand that step. Don't put a pressure of remembering the steps, because steps are being recorded. You can watch it again. If you watch three times, you'll remember the steps. Just you make sure that whatever the step I am performing, you should understand that. Now I'll click on continue without code. Visual Studio got opened. We have nothing. Now I'll go on file. I'll say open website. This is common in everywhere, in Word document you have, in Paint you have. So we have opened the Visual Studio. Till this, everything, everyone, are you all good with this till this point? Put down yes if it is okay, or yes, put down quickly. So we have opened Visual Studio and we copied the path of the project. Here we have our website or project, whatever you say. Now I will say file, and I will open website. I will say open website. Now I will just browse. Where is my website? I'll just go to, I can put the path here directly. Dev folio, part-time pre-bootcamp dev folio, or you can explore this also. I'll press enter. You got this dev folio. We have pasted the path, or you can also browse this. Now I'll say open. Now our project got opened, but to see our project, we should go for View Solution Explorer. Here we have our project. Our project will be in Solution Explorer. I'll close this. If you miss this, you can get it back from View Solution Explorer. And here we have index page. I'll double click on this index page. This is our index page. Now by looking at this, can you understand that this is HTML file, full HTML file. You have head tag, body tag. In head tag, you have meta tag, title. Now let me go back to the folder. This is a folder. I'll double click this. I'll say open with Google Chrome. This is what we have. Let me close this, and also close this. Now, this is the output, you can say. This is the output. Fine, this is the output. This is our code. This is output and this is our code. Do you all understand this? See you, if I take my mouse pointer on index.html, you see the path e: part-time bootcamp, pre-bootcamp, depfolio, index.html, and this is the output e: part-time bootcamp, pre-bootcamp, depfolio, index.html. Code and output, have you all understood? We have code and we have output. Everyone type in yes quick. I want a response quickly from everyone. I want everyone to be active, alert, and quickly say yes if you have understood, and if you have doubt you can ask. Now if we make some changes here, it will reflect here. Now you see, this is the title: Devfolio Bootstrap Template. Devfolio Bootstrap Template. Title. Here we have title. Devfolio Bootstrap Template. I will remove this. I will say MTT Folio. And I'll save this. I will save this. I'm not doing anything. Now I will jump back to the output. Has it got changed? No. If you want your output to change, you should refresh. So I'll say Control F5. Got MTT Folio? Have you all understood this step one? Those who are newbie, for them especially, because those who are experienced, for them it is not at all a big deal. But almost everyone is newbie here. So for them, I'm just saying, we got our MTT Folio. Now here dev folio is the icon. This is menu. You can see this. This is the menu or navigation bar, you can say. This is menu or navigation bar. Now let me go back to code. Scroll down. This is one thing that we did in head tag. Now I'll close head tag. Now I'll open body tag. Everything is in body now. And I can also close the solution explorer. If I want it back, I can go to view. I can say solution explorer. Now you see, this is your navigation bar. And it says navigation start, navigation end. You try to understand the parts of your page. Navigation bar, navigation start, navigation end. Intro start. Intro end. Intro start, intro end. You see, I am Morgan Freeman. I'll just shift to output. This is navigation. Start, navigation, end. This is intro start, intro end, till this part. See, this is one part, this is the second part. Then you have third part, about me, you see. Then you have the third part, section, which has div tags. So I'll just minimize this. This is a section, and in this you see you will have about me, name, profile, email, phone. Do you see? Name, profile, email, phone. This is about me section. You can see, with ID you can see about. ID is about. Now this ID is services. Now I'll shift back to output. You have services section. Web design, web development, photography, responsive design, graphic design, marketing service. I'll shift back to code. You have services. Services. Web design. Web development. Photography. Responsive design. Graphic design. Marketing services. So I'll minimize this section. So we are just understanding. Then you have you can say your performance. We have completed 450 projects and we have 15 years of experience and we have total 550 clients and awards we won. So something you are talking about yourself or your company. Section counters, so we call it as counters. Now if I click on services, now if I scroll down, you see I'll reload the page. Now you see these counters are getting reloaded. So I'll shift back to the code. This is your counterpart. Then section portfolio. Section portfolio. Portfolio in the sense, what all the things that we have done. We have done this project, we have done this project, we have done. If I click on this, it will open the image. That's it. I'll close this. Click on this, open the image. I can navigate left, next, left, left. I'll close this. I'll click on this. I'll close. So these are the projects that I have worked. So we call it as portfolio. So this is the portfolio part. So how neatly they have, what you can say, separated the code and the various sections. So it is work, the work that we have done. ID. Testimonials. Testimonials means what do our clients says about, what do our clients say about us? Clients. We have one client. Two clients. We have only two clients. You can see this. Testimonials. One client, two clients. We have two clients. This is one client. This is another client. Testimonial box. Are you all with me? Testimonial box. One, testimonial box. Two. We have two clients in the testimonials. I'll go back blogs section. Have you written any blogs? If you have written, that's fine. Now for my website, I don't want blogs. Assume that I don't want blogs for my website. Now I'll select this blog section. Start till end. I will just delete this and I'll say save. I'll go back. And I say F5. Now, do you see blog section? No, we do not have blog section anymore. Control Z, you have. We got Control Z. If you say Control Z, we got our blog sections back. Are you all with me? Then we finally have footer. I'll say Control F5. We got the blog section. I'll save this, Control S, Shift, Control F5. We got our blogs section back. Then you have finally the footer where you have get in touch, your address, and you have your contact form. You can see that. I'll just shift to the code. Now I hope you people are aware of this thing, those who have done input tag, email type, input text box name, email, text area. We have button, submit button. So you people are aware of all those things. Get in touch, you have just address, and finally you have footer. See, all the links in the footer should remain intact. You can delete the links only if you purchase the pro version. If you purchase this, then you can remove these links, but because we are not purchasing, it is free. So I'll leave the copyrights as is. Licensing to Boots trap made. So we'll not touch all these things. So if you want, you can remove this and copyright, and you can write your name, MTT Folio, all rights reserved, and whatever you want. So have you all understood the structure of the page? Say yes, everyone. Those who have understood, type in yes. Now we'll start editing. Yeah, I think Masa, you have you gone through HTML and CSS course, video course? Full. Okay, very good. Now see what is it I'm telling. I don't want you to understand each and every bit of the code, but the overview, I mean to say, like, you know, by looking at this, you should say, okay, this is this section, this is this section. I want you to understand that this is navigation bar section, and here you have dev folio. So this dev folio is reflecting on your output at this point. Now you can do one more thing. If you want to observe that, you can right click on dev folio and you say inspect. So it will show you the code. We call it as debug window. Now I'll click on this mouse pointer. Now I'll select this navigation. So see, this is the navigation menu. Navigation start, navigation end, same thing. Intro start, intro end. About start, about end. Services, counter, work, testimonials, blog, everything what we have seen, the code, the complete code is here. Just I want you to understand the page structure by looking at this. Now I will go back to the code. Instead of dev folio, I will make it as MTT folio, and I'll save this. Now I'll go back to the output window. I'll close this. And I'll say Control F5. Got MTT folio. I think this edit, everybody can do it, right? Masa? We have our ready-made template, and we can change. Yeah, from preview screen you can change the code, but it will not get reflected. So we are not going to change the code from there. What we are going to do, we are going to change it in our Visual Studio and save it and look it at this position. I'll just go back to the code. In navigation bar, I want home, yes. I want about us, yes. I want services, yes. I want work, yes. But I don't want blog, so I'll remove this blog item, blog link. Every link is an anchor tag, and it is list item. And all the links are unordered list with some predefined classes. So unordered list. List item. So I don't want this block. I will remove this link item. And for this contact, I don't want it to display contact. I'll say get in touch. So whatever you want. So these are all menu items we are changing. Now I'll save this. Go back to MTT folio. I'll say Control F5. Got home, about us, services, work, get in touch. Now we do not have blog in menu item. Are you all good with these changes? everyone. Very good. Now I will go back to the code. I'm done with my navigation bar. I'll open the intro and I'll say I'll change this Morgan Freeman, Manzoor the trainer. And you have span tags. I'll just press enter. I'll take it into the new line. In this you have CEO dev folio. So I'll say CEO MDT folio, web developer, web designer, front end developer. I'm not a graphic designer. I'm a teacher. I'll save this. I have saved this. I'll go back. I'll now say control F5. Got it. I'm Manzoor the trainer, web designer, front end developer, and a teacher. So this is how we do. Now I'll just go to about me, name. About my name. Muhammad Manzoor Ahmed. Profile, full stack developer. Email, phone number, my contact number. Email, I'll say info@manzoorthetrainer.com. My phone number +91 96760 10101. This is my mobile number, my phone number. If you want to add one more attribute, you can copy this. You can paste it. Profile, email, phone, and say you want to add qualification, and in the span I'll write I'm a Microsoft certified trainer, or we'll say certification. Certifications, Microsoft certified trainer, Microsoft certified professional developer, and I'll write and Microsoft certified technology specialist. So I'll save this, go back to the output, take control F5. So do you see name, profile, and all the things? Skills, you have HTML, CSS, PHP, JavaScript. I'll go back to the skills. HTML. In HTML, okay, I'm 85%. Now, if you want to show this progress bar, it is 85%. So what you need to do in this progress bar, you should set the maximum value 100. And the value now is 85, and width is also 85. Now CSS3, I will change it to 95%. This is what I am displaying. Width is also 95%. Value now is also 95, and max value is 100. I'll leave this as is. I'll go back. Now I'll say control F5. do you see CSS3 is now 95%. Go back. PHP, no, I'm not a PHP developer. I'm Microsoft.NET developer. And 90%. And I'll make the width as 90%. And the value now is 90%. Maximum is 100%. And JavaScript, I will leave it as is. Now I'll copy this. I'll copy this because I want one more. I want one more skill. I want Microsoft SQL Server. See, whatever I'm teaching now in 1 hour, some institutes, they will take 1 month and they will teach all these things. They'll say, what is class? This, no, when you go to the real time, you are not going to write all this, script code. You take a template, you edit it. Our actual job is to write C# program. Our actual job is to go for, writing business logic. Our actual job is to design API. Our actual job is to, create database. Our actual job to implement security. This, we'll never waste our time in, coding all these UI templates. To go to the market, you can purchase templates, awesome templates just by paying few dollars. That's it. So in SQL Server, I'll say 95. I'll say 95 and 95. Now I'll save this. Go back to the code, say Control F5. Now you see Microsoft SQL Server with 95. Are you all good with this, everyone? Very good. What about Massa? Are you getting things? I think Massa, you did not attend our first session, right? You joined today. Today is the first session for you. Okay, very good. Now I'll go back about me. Now I don't want all these three paragraphs about me. I want to write only two paragraphs. That's it. Remove this about me. I'll just try to get it from bootcamp.manzoorthetrainer.com. So from here till here, I'll put it as first paragraph. Save this. From here till here, I'll put it as second paragraph. And I'll paste it. I'll save this. Go back to the output. Say Control F5. Got it? We'll change images at the end. We'll look for images at the end. We got about me. Services, okay, I do web designing, I do web development, I do not do photography, I do not do graphic design, I do not do marketing services. I do only these three things: web design, web development, responsive design. These three things I do not do. I'll remove these three things. From the services, web design, yes, I do. So you have service box one. This is one. This is web development. Yes, I do. This is photography. I do not do this. This div tag I'll remove. This photography I do not do. Then you have responsive design. Yes, I do responsive design. Graphic designs I do not do. I'll remove this div tag. Just to edit existing code, we need a common sense. That's it. Now, marketing services, no, I do not do this. I'll remove this. Now, in this web design, what is that I do? What do I do in web design? I code on HTML, CSS, HTML 5, CSS 3, Angular 9, and here I'll write JavaScript, Angular 9, and TypeScript. So in this way, you can edit the text, whatever you have. So I'll save this. Go back, say Control F5. So went out through the tab. Text is aligned in the center. So we'll write the less code. We changed title and text because it is a paragraph tag. So whatever we write, it will be in this format. Control F5. So we have learned in paragraph tag, you can just write it in multi lines. Now, just you make sure that when you design, you should have equal content on each part so that it should align good. You should have equal content. So this is what you need to keep in your mind. Now, these counters, you can just go back. Now these are the counters that you have. Work completed, works instead of works, I'll say projects completed. Also 750 years of experience. I'll just write 20 total students taught. I'll just write 1000 awards won, or you can say certifications. I'll say certifications I have done. So I'll say I have done some 10 certifications. So whatever you want. Now I'll save this. Go back, Control F5. See, this is how you can edit. Portfolio, I'll leave it as is. If you want, you can also edit the portfolio, but I don't want to edit the things in the portfolio because we have some images. We will see how to change the images. I'm leaving it as is. Testimonials, yes, fine. We have two testimonials. Oh, I want two more. So I'll just copy this, two testimonials, and I'll paste it. I'll get four testimonials. You see that. Control F5. You got four. 1, 2, 3, 4. Are you all with me? we got four testimonials. Now you can change the images. How to change the images? We will see that titles and all these things you can change. I'm just changing one. So we have got a testimonial from Amon. And you can see what he says. We have Amon. The way you break out the complex is really amazing, memorizing and all this. I'll just copy this. Amon, from my last batch, or you know, I think in the second batch, he's working in Infosys USA. He's really doing good. I'll go back. So Control F5. You can see this. We got Amon. An image, we will see how to change. So this is how you can do. You have blogs. I hope now you got an idea, right? To edit, you got well versed with all these things. You have blogs, you have footer. Now the important part I want to show you from footer is, this form tag. We have a form tag. You see this. This is the form tag we have. Now this form is an inbuilt form, and you have some validation and all these things, and it requires you to write the server side code. Like you need to pass this data to your C# code, and from there you should configure SMTP. You should send an email, write the code to send an email. So in our project or in our web API course, we will see how to send the emails, how to write the code. But here I'm going to show you one interesting feature for forms. I will remove this form from here. I will remove the form from here. And I'm going to integrate Google Forms. Have you heard about Google Forms? How many of you have heard about Google Forms? See that, what Google is giving us. I'll go to, everyone might have your Gmail account, right? Now you can just click on this dots and click on Drive. You have G Drive, we call it as G Drive, Google Drive. So here you can click on New. I'll go for More, Google Forms, G Drive, New, Google Forms. I'll click on this Google Forms. Everyone, those who have Gmail account, you'll have all these things. Now you can give some title to the form. Form title, contact us. Now, what are the things that you want? First thing, first question, you can ask first question. I click on this. Ask a question. Question means enter name. Is it a multiple choice? No, it is not a multiple choice. It is a normal short answer. Your name is a normal short answer. Is it a required field? I'll say yes, required. You got one field. I'll add one more field or one more question, you can say. You got another question. And here I want email. This is also a short answer. Automatically it has selected, you see this. And it is a required field. It is also required. So you'll get a star mark if it is required. And here we have few more things. Response validation. That means it should be a text, and that text should be an email address. So it will not take anything other than email address. Are you all getting the things required? Here you have the options. Then I'll add one more field and I'll say comments or whatever the query you have. And it is a see, it has automatically taken paragraph. Normally comments are paragraphs. Are you all with me? And it is also a required field. And you want one more field, I'll add one more question. And I can drag this and I can take this question up. You can rearrange. I want this question to be gender. I want to correct the gender. Gender is not multiple choice. Yeah, multiple choice. Option one, male. Add another option. Automatically it has taken female. See that, how sharp it is. It is also required. That's it, we are done with our form. Copy this and I'll name it as contact us form. Now I will click on this preview. You can see this form. I can copy this URL and I'll send it to you. Can you click on this and see that it is working? Very good. You have themes. This UI, I want it to match with my UI. So you can just go for some different colors, color combination. Normally you see this is something, navy blue. It looks like navy blue. I want this theme then, not this. This theme I want. Background color also I need this. So it should match. If you want to have some image in the header, you can have it. Font style, it is basic, or you want to change something, you can change it. Now, what you can do, one thing to collect information, you can share the link. But what I want, I'll go to settings, click on settings. I'm not going to do anything. Limit to one response. That means everybody can add only one response and it requires signing if you say that. So because it is normal generic inquiry form, we need not to limit it to one response. They can have a number of responses. Are you all getting the things? I'll cancel this. Now I'll click on send. Now, if you want, you can mail it to someone, but I don't want that. If you want, you can share the link, but this is a long link. No, I don't want to share a long link. I want to share a short link. Short links look good and people will not get scared on clicking short links. This is a short link. But I don't want share the link also. I want to embed. So this is embed tag. I want to embed. You got width and height. Width, I want to change it to 340. I want a smaller width so that it should fix in my UI. I'll click on copy. It is an iframe tag. It is an iframe tag. I have copied this. That's it. I have copied. Now I'll go back to my source code and I'll paste it here in div tag. Got it? Width and height. I'll save this. Now you see the magic. In MTT folio, I'll say Control F5. Got a form, contact us form. You have got scroll bar. So I'll increase the height. There is no problem. What is wrong in it? I'll make it to 900 pixels. Say Control F5. Little more I can increase. I'll change it to 1000 pixels. I think I need to decrease the size to remove scroll bar. No, you do not have any scroll bar here. Width also I can increase a little. If you want, I can increase a little width to look good. See, it's up to you to set. I'll say 440. Control F5. Got it. Now I'll write Manzoor, email info@manzoorthetrainer.com, gender male, I'll submit. This is a required field, you should write it. It will not allow you to do that. And if I do not write a valid email address, it will say that email address must be valid. This is really cool. Now I'll say submit. It says your response has been submitted or recorded. Now you if you log in and if you see in my drive, I'll refresh this. If you see in my drive, because we created the form, right? You got your contact us form. Now I'll close all these things, what we have opened earlier. Are you all good with the audio now? Everyone? Very good. I think there was some network issue. So I just reconnected it. So till where you were with me? So we integrated this form. Were you with me when I submitted the form? When I submitted the form, were you with me, everyone? Very good. So if a client wants to interact with us and they have submitted the form, now I will go to my Gmail account, G Drive, and I'll open the form. Contact us form here we have. This is the question and this is the response. I'll click on the response. You see one response we have. We have got one response from Manzoor. This is the email address, this is the gender, and this is what they want to ask. Are you all with me? Now, you see, this is a question and this is a response. I'll click over here. I'll click here. And I will say, get email notification for new responses. I don't want to come to this form every time and I don't want to check the response. What I want is, if somebody, I'll just say Control F5, if somebody is making any kind of request, I should get an email in my inbox. I should get an email in my inbox. So for example, it's Peter, my favorite student always. Peter@gmail.com, and he wants to join part-time bootcamp. Say submit. Now I won't go for form and to G Drive and check every time. I'll just look into my inbox. My Gmail should have an alert. If you should see it shortly, it will arrive shortly, saying that there is a new response. We created here, yes. Google Forms, your form contact us has new response. So this is interesting. You have a new response. If you want, you can view summary from here. It will open the form. Now you should see two responses. And if you want these responses in the form of Excel sheet, click on create a spreadsheet. Do you want to create new spreadsheet? Yes, I'll say create. It will open an Excel sheet. You see that. And it will link it to this. Now you have form contact us information in the Excel sheet. And this Excel sheet is also available in our drive. G Drive, you will find one Excel sheet with the name contact us. So we have contact us form. This form is linked to this Excel sheet. This Excel sheet is working like database for this form.
I have a question, sir.
Yes.
Can we have something like official email to get notified when there is a response on the form? Instead of having it on the Gmail, can we get the notification?
Yes, I got your point. See, you will get a notification with the ID that you make the form. See, Google also supports custom domains. Now, info@manzoorthetrainer.com. I have integrated manzoorthetrainer.com on Gmail. So I need not to go to some other, like MS Outlook or something to have my. Now here I can create. Here also I have Drive. I can create a form here. Now I'll get the, things in my email. But if you are saying that some explicit email address, I want to set it from here. No, we do not have that.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, welcome. Download as CSV, you can do that. So I hope this is something interesting feature that we have done. Now finally we are done with our complete portfolio. Now I'll go back to the code, Visual Studio, View, Solution Explorer. You can see here you have a folder image, and here you have images. Any image that you want to change, for example, you want to change this image that the man is standing behind the scene. This image you want to right click and say inspect. You see style background image intro-bg. Now you can see this intro-bg here. Same thing. If I double click this, it will open, right? But I'm not going to open it here. I'll right click. I'll say open with. Here you have, you do not have paint, so better go to the folder images. Now you can see clearly here, you need not to worry much about whatever the image you want to change. You want to change this intro BG. Do remember one point here. You go to the properties of the image, and in details you have size 1920 by 1055. This is width and height. This size should match. If you want to replace this image, make sure that you replace with the image of this size. For example, I want to replace this image, right? I want to replace this image, testimonial 2. I'll just right click testimonial 2. I'll say open with paint. I can just open with paint also. You see its size is 150 by 150. Its size is 150 by 150. Now what I will do, I think I have some images of mine on desktop. Yes, I'll open with paint. This is in full size. I'll just resize it to pixels 150 by 150. Got it. I'll save this as JPEG to same folder e:, part-time bootcamp, pre-bootcamp, portfolio, images. I want to replace this, right? Testimonial 2. I'll select this. I'll say save. It will say, do you want to replace? I'll say yes, I want to replace. Now go back to your website. Say Control F5. See that image got replaced. Are you all with me, everyone? If you are with me, just type in yes. You know what? I think we took little longer time because of network connection and all those things. So don't you think now you can go to any hotel, any restaurant, any school or any small business, and you can talk to them and you can say that I can create a static website for you with contact us form. And if anybody wants to contact you, they can contact you through, contact us form, and you'll get an email. Can't you do that? And you can easily charge them $1,000 or $2,000, and you can just buy a what do you say, theme for, or one template for $10, $12 or $15, you can do that. So what we have seen, we have developed, but we have not, it is on my local system. We have not hosted it live so that it should be available throughout the world. Like this MTT folio. So how to host it live, we will see tomorrow. I'm going to send you your subdomains on Manzoor the Trainer. And I want to create your portfolio. Assume that you have completed this bootcamp and you create your portfolio and you develop. This is the job that I'm giving. And it is not must that you should take the same template. You can take any template that you like. You can take any template, edit it and implement it. And I'll give you subdomains and some username and passwords. You keep it safe. And tomorrow I will show you how to host it live to the server. So that's it for the day. I hope you might have enjoyed today's session.